Hello everyone, this is Jesus from Hustling Labs, and today we're going to be talking about how to build a notification system. Pretty sure you are familiar with notification systems like the one that you experience in Facebook, in your phone, in your bank website, and many other platforms out there. And they're used to remind users about certain tasks that needs to be done or that need to get the user's attention, right? Before we jump into how to build a notification system, I would like to talk to you a little bit more about what kind of apps will benefit from using this kind of notifications. And the biggest one and the most glaring one is messaging and communication apps, WhatsApp, Signal, and similar type of applications that when a user sends a message, you want the other user to get notified so that message doesn't just go into the void. Another one is social media apps, so similar to Facebook, LinkedIn, and many other similar social media applications. And they're used to notify users about their likes, comments, shares, friend requests, photos, and that kind of stuff. And the next one are e-commerce apps, and they're used to inform about sales, new product arrivals, and order status updates. And before we continue, it's worth mentioning that these notifications can be different, right? So they can be push notifications, they can be notifications within the application or the software, they can be emails, and there are different type of notifications that could be used. And today we're going to be focusing something internal and that perhaps we can expand in future videos. So some other type of applications, and I will go down the list really fast, that could benefit from notification system are news apps, again, finance and banking apps, health and fitness apps, event and calendars, gaming, travel and navigation, and directories, productivity apps, streaming, and lastly but not least, food delivery and restaurant apps similar to Uber Eats and DoorDash and those kind of software applications. Now that we know which kind of applications will benefit from using a notification system, I want to jump in and not waste your time. Let's start building, and we're going to start with the database. This is a project that I've been working on. It's a site that I will be using to showcase the plugins and for people to demo them. But we're going to jump in and start building. So we're going to build two different data types, so the notifications and notification settings. So the notifications will have a link to which user is going to be receiving the notification. It's going to be a list, just in case it's more than one. And the next one is going to be the notification itself. So let's have title for the notification, and let's have a content for the notification. There are some apps that only use just one of them, and that's completely fine. We're going to be using both. Let's see. This one is going to be the type. And what we're going to do is we're going to first go to the option sets. Option set. And this is going to be message. If you see me looking to the side, I have my notes here. Move this one up just to have an order. And yep. And we're going to go back to the data types and create this. And the next one is going to be status. We're going to create an option set. And this is going to be either unread, read, or deleted. So again, and by default, this one is going to be unread because every notification is first unread. And that's it for this. for the notification settings, we're going to link this to a new user. So we make sure that we know who the settings belong to. Then we're going to have an allows push notifications. This is going to be a Boolean, yes or no. Make this faster. And yes or no, whether or not they allow email notifications and SMS. And that's it. All right, what we want to do from here is we want to let's create a page. And this is going to be a notifications page. And basically what we want to do is we want to add a button. It doesn't matter. Send notification. And what we're going to do is that every time we are going to click the button, there is a notification created. Like this, a column. Just enter, just for the sake of it. And what we want to add is an input for the title. Notification title, input, then a multi-line input. It's going to be notification content. And add this content is going to be the notification content multi input. Notification status on red. The notification type, and this is alert. A receiving user, we're going to add current user because just to keep it simple. And this is the notification title input. All right, now what we want to do is we want to add down here iPhone. It's going to be a notification icon. It's going to be in the middle. In addition to that, we're going to add a shape. And then we're going to make it round. And this is going to be red. And we're going to group them together in a row. The row will fit the content. And this is going to move to the left. And go down a little bit. Making this really big just to make sure that you can see. We're going to make this disappear. Now we're going to do a search for notifications. The receiving user contains current user, contains current user, and the count is bigger or equal than one. And this will be visible when that happens. So let's preview this and see what we got so far. Again, this is not aesthetically pleasing, but as you can see, we got the title here, the contents and notification, and there's nothing here. So we're going to add my name in hello world. Set the notification, as you can see, disappears here. So the next step we're going to do is we're going to create a group focus that we are going to have attached to group A. And within the group focus, we're going to have a repeating group that is going to be notifications. It's going to do a search for notifications, the receiving user, contains, current user. And it's going to be as many rows as is needed. At the top, it's going to have the title, search notification title, and then it's going to have the content down there. It's going to span as long as is needed to group them together, column, so we can add some space in between. This one is going to be, let's see, make sure we can distinguish. All right, that means that we're going to add a workflow that toggles focus A. All right, so let's go to this page and let's make sure that we actually have a notification, even though it disappears here. And here we go. Jesus Vasquez, hello world. Let's add another one. And hello, my people. And then as you can see, it's down here. So now what we want to do is we want to reverse this. So the notification is going to be sorted back. Created day, and not descending. And let's make sure that I got it right. I believe I did, but let's make sure it's correct. Yes. Yes. And it's being created. Now, the next thing that we want to do is for the notification settings, this workflow is only going to run if we're going to do a search for notification settings, the user equals, let's say current user in this case, and the push notification is yes. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go grab this user unique ID, and we're going to create a notification setting. And we're going to make sure it's attached to the right user. What is the search for? All right, so all of them are going to be yes. So we're going to go back here and you're going to see the difference. So, and all right, so there was an issue there. Let's see what happened. Okay, I know what happened. I'm not logged in. Let's log in, actually. So now that I'm logged in, there is no... no notification, but now there is one. And that notification is attached to me, receiving user. As you can see, it's with these two that are... or user that is not. All right, so let's go back to notifications. Push notification is going to be null. Return 4, return 3, click. And as you can see, it didn't create a new notification. So let's go back. Change it to yes. Click. And as you can see, it created. So it did what it needed to do. So the last part that I want to show you is for privacy. We're going to define a new rule. It's going to be self. So when this notifications receiving user contains current user, they can see it. Otherwise, you can see it. There's no easy way to demonstrate this other than creating another new user. Let's see. Then we're going to create this new user. Let's refresh this just to make sure that we can see the new user first. And trying to waste your time or anything. Let's run it. And you should not be able to see any notifications. Number one, because of the constraints that we created for the repeating group. And number two, because of the privacy rules. And that would allow those notifications to be saved just like any other data in your application that you might want to keep safe. That's all I have for you. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate you taking your time and watching this video today. It really means a lot. If you have any questions, please let me know down in the comments below. But this is the way that I create notification systems. Later on, we will talk about how to connect those to third-party APIs, such as ConvertKit to send emails, OneSignal to send push notifications, and Twilio to send SMS notifications. But for now, like I said, if you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments below. I would love to answer them. Also, please consider subscribing to the channel. It helped me reach the 1,000 subscriber goal so I can start getting paid and I can make much more content, much better content for you. That would give me an opportunity that I don't have right now to focus on this channel a little bit more. Hopefully, that will happen by the end of the year or next year after I had done my 100 Bubble plugins that I'm publishing on the Bubble Marketplace so I can have some great content out there, some great plugins, and we can rock together. Thank you for watching.